Good evening. I'd like to call a regular Village Board meeting for April 20th, 2020 to order. As part of the Governor's Executive Order in response to COVID-19, the provisions of the Illinois Open Meetings Act requiring and relative to in-person and remote attendance by members of a public body have been suspended to accommodate social distancing. Further, given the Governor's stay-at-home order and to ensure the public is able to view and participate in, the Village is conducting tonight's meeting via Zoom. Would Village Clerk Turner please call the roll?
Mayor Pisak?
Here.
Trustee Carballo? Trustee Kowitzel?
Here.
Trustee Dixit? Trustee Hasse?
Here.
Trustee Sadat?
Here.
Trustee Winds?
Here.
Trustee Carballo?
Here.
Trustee Dixit?
Here.
Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to remind all trustees that anybody making a motion or a second remotely to please start by announcing your name to make it easier for the clerk to keep record. It'll make the meeting go a little smoother. At this time, I'd like to ask everybody to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I will start tonight's meeting with two proclamations. First one is a proclamation establishing April 20th through 24th of 2020 as Flood Awareness Week in the Village of Lisle. Whereas floods often occur swiftly and can cause severe impacts with little warning, and whereas the potential for loss of life, property damage, and injury to the economy can be reduced if appropriate flood preparedness and mitigation measures are taken before and after flood events, and whereas the Village of Lisle continues to prepare for potential flood events through participating in the Community Rating System program, mitigation efforts, enforcement of floodplain regulations, public awareness, and public education activities, and whereas all Lisle residents are asked to observe Flood Awareness Week by preparing their homes and families for floods through reviewing flood safety guidance on the Village's website, as well as Federal Emergency Management Agency informational materials, and whereas flood damage is not a standard component of the average homeowner's insurance policy, and residents are encouraged to review their flood risk and ensure they have obtained proper flood damage coverage, and whereas the Village of Lisle experienced a record flood event on April 18, 2013, and whereas the Mayor and Board of Trustees of the Village of Lisle concur that a public that is well informed of the dangers associated with flooding can improve its preparedness and reduce the associated occurrence of death and injury. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed by the Mayor and Board of Trustees that the week of April 19th, 2020 is proclaimed as Flood Awareness Week. Next is a proclamation establishing April 24th, 2020 as Arbor Day. Whereas in 1872, J. Sterling Morton proposed to the Nebraska Board of Agriculture that a special day be set aside for the planting of trees. And whereas this holiday, called Arbor Day, was first observed with the planting of more than a million trees in Nebraska. And whereas Arbor Day is now observed throughout the nation and the world. And whereas trees can reduce the erosion of our precious topsoil by wind and water, cut heating and cooling costs, moderate the temperature, clean the air, produce life-giving oxygen, and provide habitat for wildlife. And whereas trees are a renewable resource giving us paper, wood for our homes, fuel for our fires, and countless other wood products. And whereas trees in our village increase property values, enhance the economic vitality of business areas, and beautify our community. And whereas trees, wherever they are planted, are a source of joy and spiritual renewal. Therefore, Christopher R. Pisak, Mayor of the Village of Lisle, do hereby proclaim April 24th, 2020 as Arbor Day in the Village of Lisle and urge all citizens to plant trees to gladden the heart and promote the well-being of this and future generations. We move on our agenda. Next item is public comment. We have one person registered for public comment, Dr. Irene Baghdadi. Will she please be connected? Do we have Dr. Baghdadi on the line?
She is on. I'm unable to unmute her.
Is this a mute concern on our end or on the commenter's end?
It doesn't look like she has a microphone configured on her computer. Ah. Or a permissions issue on her side.
Hello, can you?
Dr. Baghdadi?
Yes, my name is Irina, not Irene. But hello, it's a nice to meet you.
You'll have 5 minutes for public comment. You can proceed.
Thank you very much. I just have a minor request. If it's possible to put curbing signs on the end of our property, we do not have sidewalks here, and we have two little dogs in the house. They're in with an electric fence that we pay a lot of money for, and we have an enormous property. I was going to survey along with the easements in Illinois, but I would like curbing signs on the end of our property. I don't know how to go about it appropriately, so I thought I would join and come to the meeting. People walk their dogs, and they, you know, go into the Hitchcock Woods across the street, which is fine. It's just that most of them that come, especially with big dogs, and do have excretion devices, is a little bit upsetting, you know, no plastic bags or anything. So that's all I wanted to say. If I had to, you know, show the easements on the corners of Hitchcock and Illinois, because I've, you know, come and asked about this when it was open back in 2017, and they gave me all of the footage, et cetera, et cetera. So that was it. I was just hoping to get curbing signs, like in between the red hydrant and the light post, and outside of what where an imaginary sidewalk is right now, and on the other side on Hitchcock Woods, that people would pick up their dog litter. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Moving on our agenda, on our regular agenda, first item is Village Board regular meeting minutes approval. May I have a motion to approve the April 6th, 2020 regular meeting minutes?
Trustee Sadat moved.
Thank you, Trustee Sadat. We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Trustee Hasse will second.
Okay. Any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Hearing none, the motion passes. Next item is our voucher list. I may have a motion to approve the April 20th, 2020 voucher list in the amount of $427,582.18.
Trustee Hasse will first.
Thank you. We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Trustee Kowitzel, second.
Thank you. Any public comment? None here. Any Village Board discussion? Hearing none, Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on to our regular agenda, first item is an ordinance adopting the annual budget for the fiscal year beginning May 1st, 2020 and ending April 30th, 2021. May I have a motion to approve this ordinance?
Trustee Coetzel, so moved.
Trustee Sadat, second.
Thank you for the motion and the second. Would Finance Director Schuler please provide an overview of this item?
Thank you. Good evening, Mayor and members of the board. Staff is pleased to present the Village of Lisle's fiscal year 2020-2021 annual budget for final approval. The Village's management team has worked diligently to manage expenditures within budget constraints while continuing to deliver a high level of services to the community. The annual budget process began in the fall and included a review and analysis of revenue trends, as well as discussion regarding property tax levy options. Expenditure budgets were prepared based on distributed targets and were reviewed in detail by the Village budget team. Staff refined and revised budget numbers after further analysis, discussion with the Village board, and public input. The proposed budget was published and made available to the public in mid-February and was presented at a public hearing on March 16th. Immediately following the hearing, the COVID-19 pandemic required staff to reevaluate and revise revenue and expenditure projections. Staff was able to quickly change the proposed budget within a two-week period to address the anticipated impact of COVID-19. The revised revenue projections are conservative and take into account GFOA guidance and historical data from the 2008 recession. The updated projections, along with the modified capital improvement program and other reductions to operating expenditures, were presented to the Village Board on April 6th. Despite the unexpected conditions and uncertainty due to COVID-19, the fiscal year 2020-2021 annual budget provides for and accommodates the following: investments in maintaining and improving the Village's infrastructure, prioritizing expenses in a manner that seeks to derive the greatest value for Lisle residents, establishes sustainable financing that is forward-looking and represents prudent financial planning, enables increased productivity and innovation, allowing the organization to continually adapt to the changing needs of the community, and safeguards taxpayer revenues and is mindful of tax burdens. The resulting fiscal year 2020-2021 budget reflects total revenues of $33,916,363 and total expenditures of $35,172,543, with an estimated fund balance for all funds of approximately $77.1 million at 4/30/21. The Village continues to meet fund balance policies for all Village funds, including the general fund policy of reserving for 50% of operating expenditures. The variance between revenue and expenditures is funded by prior budget years' unrestricted operating fund balances. Total budget revenues for the fiscal year, as I had previously mentioned, equals $33,916,363, with the general fund representing 44.6% of the total revenue budget. Taxes represents the largest category at 54.18% and includes property tax, sales tax, income tax, use tax, telecommunications tax, utility tax, motor fuel tax, and the hotel motel tax. The second largest category is charges for services at 23.01% and includes water and sewer fees and commuter parking fees. The total revenue budget for the general fund is $15,127,547. The largest revenue source is taxes, which accounts for about 78% of total revenues. The 2019 property tax levy is equal to the 2018 levy at approximately $4.9 million and is about 32% of the total general fund revenue budget. Total budgeted expenditures equals $35,172,543, with the general fund representing 49.6% of the total expenditure budget. Salary and benefits represents about 43% of the total budget and includes salaries for full and part-time employees, pension payments to police pensioners, health insurance, and contributions to village pensions. The next largest category at 30.76% is contractual services and includes professional and outsourced services. The total expenditure budget for the general fund is $17,451,482, with nearly 50% of expenditures in the police emergency management budget and approximately 27% of expenditures in the public works, facilities, and fleet services budget. The capital improvement program budget for FY 2020-21 is $3,117,800. This represents about 9% of the total budget. Streets and infrastructure make up the largest percentage at about 53%, or approximately $1.6 million. Projects in this category include $1,330,000 for the annual street rehabilitation program for construction and engineering, $100,000 for the Lyle Township roadway improvement participation, $97,800 for the Abbey Wood and Greens Trail engineering, $75,000 for a commuter and downtown parking study, and $20,000 for a fountain replacement at Prairie Walk Pond. Other capital projects budgeted include $700,000 for water main improvements, $260,000 for stormwater improvements, $200,000 for new leaf vacuums, $120,000 for sanitary sewer lining, $55,000 for technology improvements, $50,000 for the replacement of a police pursuit vehicle, $45,000 for building improvements at the police station and village hall, $40,000 for phase two engineering of the Warrenville Road Bridge replacement project, and $25,000 for water sampling stations. We are proud to present a balanced and prudent budget that addresses both the current and future needs of the village. Staff recommends approval of the proposed ordinance adopting the annual budget for the fiscal year beginning May 1st, 2020 and ending April 30th, 2021. Thank you.
Thank you for that report. There was nobody signed up for public comment. Is there any board discussion? We will start with Trustee Coetzel, who made the motion.
My compliments to all the hard work and fiscal responsibility on the budget. And maybe if this continues, we may have to revisit it, depending on what goes on in the great unknown of this crisis. But I really commend everyone who worked so hard to react to this situation. Thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Sadat, who seconded?
No, just pretty much what Trustee Quizzle has stated. Thank you so much for trimming the fat wherever it is that you guys could come up with, including having that continued outlook in putting projects together that will enhance our infrastructure and continue to provide a great service to the rest of the project. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Trustee Sadat. Trustee Wins?
Yeah, thanks for all the hard work. It must be very difficult, and it's obvious that you guys really put a big rush in this to get this going for us. So thank you very much for that. I'd like to remind people that when we have the discussion about freezing taxes, that it's circumstances just like this that you prepare for when you try to build your revenue. I think it was noted in our last week's meeting that the budget was that our sales tax revenue was down before the COVID virus, and staff had recommended that we had a slight increase in our taxes in order to maintain capital funding and so we could approve all these projects. They would have had a lot more leeway with the numbers that they were trying to work with in an emergency situation like this if we could have been preparing a little bit more for these types of emergency situations. So when I voted against the tax freeze, it was cautiously preparing for moments like this. And I want to remind the taxpayer, you know, while taxes get expensive and none of us like to pay them, there's times like this that we should be proud to pay them because we can continue our project. So So without having to go to these emergency funds and start robbing Peter to pay Paul type of scenario. So I appreciate staff for recommending that back when we first proposed it, the tax levy. And I appreciate you guys doing magic to make something happen in an emergency like this when we weren't really planning for this type of an emergency. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Trustee Wins. Trustee Hasse?
Just to say thank you to staff for all of the work and hours that have put into this budget. I know it's very time-consuming to create a budget, and especially one that is fiscally responsible. So thank you all for all of your hard work. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Trustee Carballo?
Yes, I also want to thank Finance Director Shuler for all the work she's done in preparing the budget. And I am in general agreement with the budget. The only thing that I would say, as I mentioned at the last meeting, I'm personally opposed to cutting budgets for capital improvements, especially for infrastructure. When we have scheduled infrastructure improvements that are going to go on, when we cut these, especially in this time, I personally don't think it's a good idea to do so, because I think that at this time, given the economic situation that the country is in, I think it is a good time to spend money on infrastructure, and we do have the money. It's been it has been previously budgeted, and I also would thank our prior boards for being fiscally responsible for the reserves that have been built up over the years. But I think it's a good time to be spending money that's been budgeted to improve our infrastructure and to maintain our infrastructure. Also, interest rates are at an all-time low. I think that the interest rates are probably going to go up over time. And I think a lot of times when you delay improvements for capital improvements for infrastructure, it ends up in the long run costing more money down the road, you know, by waiting. And for that reason, I think that we should have included especially the capital improvements for infrastructure that were taken out of this year's budget, included those in the budget. But overall, I think it's a good budget. I appreciate all the hard work that was done to prepare this and then to revise it given the current situation, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Trustee Carballo. Trustee Dixit?
Just a big round of thank yous to the finance team.
I'm sorry, Trustee Dixit, can you move your microphone a little closer?
Can you hear me better?
A little bit better.
I just wanted to say thank you to the finance team to making it this year's budget, and definitely kudos to acting in our current environment to the village's best interest. So thank you.
Thank you. Does that conclude your comments?
Yeah.
Thank you. And one more time, Trustee Quetzal, anything further?
Just reminding everybody that municipal governments rely on revenue streams such as sales tax, income tax, motor fuel tax, all of which are greatly impacted by this economic circumstance that we're facing. So again, the conservatism is appreciated.
Trustee Sadat.
Nothing further.
Trustee Wins.
Excuse me. Yeah, I'm speaking to Trustee Carballo a on the capital improvement project or portion of this. What procedures, like if things open back up quickly, like let's say in the next 4 to 6 weeks, we're back in the swing of things, how cumbersome is it to reinitiate these capital improvement programs with the budget to make sure we can get right back on track with the plans that we've had thus far?
Is that a question to Trustee Carballo, or is that a question to staff?
Staff, I suppose.
Okay. Does staff have an answer?
Yeah, so in some of these cases where we have resolutions and purchase orders that are being approved, for example, this evening on the road program, it is a little more difficult when we're getting engineering plans ready to go and providing direction and contracts to our contractors to quickly pivot on some of these. But I don't know if Director Elias has any further thoughts on, you know, if things turn around, are we able to add additional projects depending on which infrastructure project it is?
Sure. I would just say, to echo Manager Hertmode's point, it really just depends on the project and where we're at on the project. If we're in the construction phase of the project or if we're in the design phase of the project, construction phase, depending on the project, and where we're at currently in construction, it can be a little more difficult. Just depends. You know, 4 weeks from now, we might be able to add streets back in. 6 weeks from now, most likely not. It just depends on where we're at in the construction time frame. Design projects that were deferred, easier to get back going because there's not a contractor involved. So it really just, it depends on the time of year, how long the delay is, and what the specific project we're looking at. But certainly, you know, with discussing with the finance department, if that is a situation where we can try and move some things back up, we could bring that forward to the board for future consideration.
So it would have to come before the board again to open that?
Depending on the contract. So like, for example, the road program, adding back in what we remove would need to come back before the board because we would be increasing that contract to the point where it would need formal board approval to increase it that amount. So it just depends. If it's within the village manager spending authority, we can do that just as staff, but if it exceeds the village manager spending authority, a change order of that magnitude would have to come back to the board.
We also have to come back to the board to do a budget adjustment too if we're going to be spending outside of the original budget.
Yeah. Okay, thank you guys so much. I know it's all new world we're navigating here, so thank you guys. Appreciate you helping me out.
Trustee Hasse?
Nothing further. Thank you.
Trustee Carballo?
Nothing. Thank you.
Trustee Dixit?
Nothing. Thank you.
Okay. And I would just like to close with some of these projects that actually did reduce our revised budget were projects that came in under estimated budget. So that was a benefit that benefits us all and into the future, because once we are able to review this budget, when things normalize, the prices that we're spending now have come in lower than we anticipated. With that, Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kwitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Next item on our agenda is a resolution authorizing the repayment of funds transferred from the Water Construction Fund to the Capital Improvement Repair Replacement Fund. May I have a motion to approve this resolution?
Trustee Kwitzel, so moved.
And do we have a second?
Trustee Hasse, second.
We have a motion and a second. Would Finance Director Schuler please provide an overview of this item?
Thank you. On March 20th, 2007, the Village Board approved a resolution authorizing the transfer of $7.1 million from the Water Construction Fund to the Capital Improvements Repair Replacement Fund to finance public improvements associated with the downtown streetscape and infrastructure improvements. The funds were to be repaid over a term of 21 years at an interest rate of 1%. During 2015, the amortization schedule was revised to extend the payoff date from April 1st, 2028 to April 1st, 2040 to increase the funds available for the annual street rehabilitation program. The balance of the loan on April 30th, 2020 will be $6,010,302.56 with interest of $921,982.56 paid through that date. During the February 17th, 2020 Committee of the Whole meeting budget discussion, staff recommended repayment of the funds owed to the Water Construction Fund from the Capital Improvements Repair Replacement Fund. Funds are available within the capital fund to pay off the balance of the loan as of 4/30/20. The village will save approximately $716,000 in interest costs, and the funds will remain within village accounts if needed for an unforeseen purpose. In repaying the fund transfer, the village will be able to properly account for the overall cash position of the water fund, which will provide a clearer picture of the fund's financial standing, contributing to an improved analysis as part of the water rate study. Staff recommends approval of the proposed resolution authorizing the repayment of funds from the Capital Improvements Repair Replacement Fund to the Water Construction Fund. Thank you.
Thank you. No public comment is signed up. Is there any board discussion regarding this item, starting with Trustee Coetzel making the motion?
I always like to clarify that that interest paid is all internal. It's all internal financing. But I really appreciate the clarity that paying off this internal loan will provide when analyzing this enterprise fund, which is important because of user-based fees that that are billed for this service.
Thank you. Trustee Hasse?
Nothing really to say that I think it's a good plan and a wise decision to do this. Thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Wins?
I have nothing to add on this. Thank you.
Trustee Sadat?
No, nothing further on this.
Trustee Carballo?
Nothing, thank you.
Trustee Dixit?
Nothing, thank you.
And once again, Trustee Coetzel?
Nothing more.
Trustee Hasse?
Nothing more, thank you.
Trustee Wins?
No, thank you.
Trustee Sadat?
Nothing, thank you.
Trustee Carballo?
No.
And Trustee Dixit?
No, thank you.
Okay, with that, Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Coetzel?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit? Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Next on our agenda is the consent agenda. All items on the consent agenda are considered routine by the village board and will be acted on as a group. These items will not be separately discussed unless a village board member so requests, in which event the item will be removed from the consent agenda and considered separately. Manager Ertmode, would you please provide an overview of each item?
Yes, thank you. Good evening, Mayor, members of the Village Board. Item A on the consent agenda is a resolution that will authorize the appropriation of motor fuel tax revenues to the road improvement projects identified in the 2020 Street Rehabilitation Program. Item B is a resolution that will authorize the execution of a contract associated with the 2020 Street Rehab Program to Geneva Construction Company in an amount not to exceed $1,417,658.75, as well as authorizing change order number one, which is a deduction in that contract amount of $234,229.75. Item C is a resolution that will authorize the execution of an agreement with Engineering Enterprises Inc. for professional engineering services not to exceed $39,958,000. This is for the for services associated with oversight of the 2020 street rehabilitation program. Item D is a resolution that will authorize the purchase of trees for the parkway plantings here in the village from the West Central Municipal League in an amount not to exceed $30,000. Item E is a resolution that will authorize a contract for sewer televising work with Sewer Tech LLC in an amount not to exceed $30,000. Item F is a resolution that will approve a contract for tree trimming and tree removal services of our parkway trees to Steve Piper and Sons in the amount not to exceed $26,080. Item G is a resolution that will authorize the execution of a contract for grass mowing services with local lawn care and landscaping in the amount not to exceed $37,705. Item H is approval of a resolution that will authorize the village manager to execute a contract for landscape and plant bed maintenance services with Berry Landscaping in the amount not to exceed $65,190. Item I will authorize an agreement for design engineering services for the Burlington Avenue and the River Drive water main improvements with Baxter and Woodman in an amount not to exceed $62,300. Item J is approval of a resolution that will authorize a contract for street sweeping services with Lakeshore, an amount not to exceed $60,100. Item K is a resolution that will authorize crack filling maintenance services with Delner in an amount not to exceed $30,000. Item L is a resolution that will waive competitive bidding and authorize a contract for the sidewalk trip hazard rehabilitation services to Safe Step in the amount not to exceed $40,000. Item M is a resolution authorizing an agreement with F.E. Moran for services related to replacement of an air handling unit in an amount not to exceed $45,174. That's for an air handler at the Public Works Administration building. Item N is approval of a resolution that will authorize the execution of an amendment to an existing legal services agreement between the village and Michelle Moore for prosecution and adjudication services. Finally, item O is a ordinance that will adopt fees, charges, and fines and other regulatory measures found in the 2021 annual fee ordinance. There'll be no adjustments to those fees as presented in the annual fee ordinance. There'll be no change from those ordinances, from those fee amounts from last year. I do want to finish up by saying I'd like to commend our vendors and our procurement services manager who have really worked with our service providers in light of this pandemic to either they've waived contracted increases or reduce them or maintain their pricing. So again, the village is very appreciative of its service partners in the private sector, and we thank them for helping us deliver quality municipal services to the community. And with that, staff recommends approval of the consent agenda. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. At this time, would any trustee like an item to be separately considered?
I would ask that item O be separately considered.
Okay. At this time, we have no public comment registered. May I have a motion to approve items A through N?
Trustee Sadat moved.
Trustee Coetzel second.
Thank you. There's a motion, a second. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Coetzel?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye. And that portion of the motion passes. Can I have a motion to approve item O?
Trustee Hasse, so moved.
Win, second.
We have a motion and a second. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Is this O?
Yes.
Okay, I thought we were going to pull that for discussion. We're taking a vote on it?
We're separately voting on it. You would like to have a discussion on it?
Yeah, I was actually, that's why I thought we were pulling it for discussion. That's why I had asked to pull it. And the reason I asked to pull that is I had mentioned at the last meeting about trying to incentivize under the extreme circumstances that we're under right now, try to incentivize businesses to come to Lisle and residents of Lisle to be able to improve their property under the circumstances that exist. And I have no problem with the ordinance establishing fees and charges. However, the one thing that you recall recently that the board received an email from Ray Swoika, who I know wanted to try to speak at the meeting tonight, but didn't get on the schedule somehow. I thought he had raised a good idea under these circumstances now that to incentivize businesses and homeowners to improve their properties and come to Lisle under these extreme circumstances, that we agree to waive certain fees in the village in order for them to certain permitting fees for them to improve their business or to bring their business to Lisle for the business side, and for homeowners to invest in their property. I know a lot of homeowners have been home and have been doing a lot of work on their properties lately since they've been at home, and I think that that's great. You see a lot of people doing spring cleaning and maintenance, but I know a lot of people have wanted to improve their properties, repair fences, replace fences, driveways, roofs, things like that. And especially now, with hopefully things coming back soon, low interest rates, and in order to incentivize them to invest in their property and improve the village, I was thinking that Mr. Swoika had a great idea to do something that basically tells the community that we want you to invest in Lisle and to improve property and for businesses to come to Lisle, to have some kind of incentive program where we agree for a period of months, for the next few months to waive certain of the fees for building permit fees, that kind of thing. So I thought that was a good suggestion. I have no problem with the ordinance establishing the charges, but I thought that, with to maybe carve in, if possible, or to address this separately, to have some kind of to discuss and have some kind of an incentive program to work with businesses and residents to incentivize them to improve and to beautify the village.
Does that conclude
That's
your
all I have.
Thank you. Trustee Hasse made the motion. Trustee Hasse, do you have any comment?
No, nothing tonight.
Trustee Wins, do you have any comments?
Yeah, I think that it sounds what Mr. Swoika and Trustee Carballo are proposing does sound like a very good idea to incentivize people. Now seems like a great time to promote people to do these exact projects that he's talking about. And I think that it would promote the social distancing to waive some of these fees. It would avoid people having to come in, and they could possibly maintain and do some of these projects that they wouldn't at another time. My question would be, how would we approve this for the future yet waive them currently? Can we do that at one time, or would that, because I'd support a motion to include waiving these fees for, say, 90 days, and then putting this in, if that was within our boundaries to make that type of a motion. I'd need advice on that from staff and the attorney, most likely.
Do we have Attorney Elliott on the line?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Can you still hear me?
Yes. We can hear you.
Yeah. Waiving fees is not on the agenda, so I would not recommend doing that. I think, and besides, I think staff would like to maybe take a look at that and give a report on it. I mean, you can approve these fees now, and you can always come back later and waive any of them that you want to. But, you know, there may be some inherent costs that the village has that the staff may want to advise people about before you go ahead and waive them. You may want to just partially waive them. But the main point is it's not on the agenda right now to do that.
Yeah, I understand that. But in the idea of expediency is what we would be hoping to accomplish. Obviously, we want to stay within the boundaries of the law. By putting this, by the sounds of it, we would have to then go to committee of the whole, have the discussion in committee of the whole, and then go to the next board meeting. I mean, we're talking 4 weeks from now if we're following that that recommendation, which I don't know if that really accomplishes what Mr. Soika and Trustee Arbalo are trying to accomplish. So if there's an alternative way other than that, I would still support that. If not, obviously, we have to stay within our boundaries.
I'd like to say something, if that's okay.
We'll get you the floor as soon as Trustee Wins has cleared. Are you all set, Trustee Wins?
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Trustee Sadat?
Thank you. I was just reviewing some of our previous meetings. We can always convene a special board meeting to address this, or we can ask to put forth a motion to waive some of these fees in the interim process. And some of the responses that I received from other villages, they do this as a special meeting where they did put this on the agenda before time, and they were able to waive it. And with our current technology that we have, pulling a special meeting together should not be a problem if I have enough consensus on the board.
Does that conclude your comments?
It does.
Thank you, Trustee Quetzal.
Even before the attorney's comments that validated my feeling, I was feeling like we were having a conversation about, we had a motion on the floor for one thing and then a conversation about another topic entirely. We're all very familiar with the fact that governmental units from local through federal are considering ideas for helping ease the pain of the current recession. Notably, DuPage County will be considering allowing some taxpayers to delay without penalty payment of the first installment of real estate taxes. I think if the village wants to consider something, it can't be so seat of the pants as this conversation seems to be. It has to be a thoughtful consideration of how that might be done and done equitably. I don't know that this particular fee proposal is necessarily the way to do it. But again, it's not what's on the agenda. As the attorney said, this agenda item is something that appears before us annually. There's no change being made to anything, and I think we need to address that topic and decide if, at another time, if we want to address this separate topic altogether. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Quetzal. Trustee Dixit, any comments?
Nothing further. I agree with Trustee Quetzal.
Thank you. Are we ready to call the vote?
I'd like to
ask. Okay, let's go back to one more round. Motion was made by Trustee Sadat. Trustee Sadat, do you have anything to add?
I don't believe the motion was
made. I'm sorry. The second motion was made by Trustee Hasse and seconded by Wentz. Trustee Hasse, do you have anything to add?
No, I just agree with what Trustee Kowitzel has said. This is two separate conversations for the future.
Okay. Trustee Wentz?
I feel like they're close enough related that it's fair for us to be having the conversation. And this is the least obtrusive way to do it. To kind of bring the topic up. So I'm thankful for Trustee Cabrallo for doing so. It creates the conversation and gets that ball rolling. I would also like to add a question to that if we were to make this motion, is it within the mayor's authority from that emergency, amendment or that we invoked the ordinance on our last board meeting, I believe it was April 6th. Could the mayor have the authority to waive these types of fees and stuff like that through that last change that we made to the emergency ordinances?
I will defer that to the attorney, both on on relative content to the agenda item as well as legality.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. There isn't really any case law on this. However, what I have seen done is that fees have, both the governor's orders and mayor's orders, have delayed the imposition of fees and waived such things as late fees. But I have not seen any orders that basically say people don't have to pay fees. I think that may be beyond the scope of an emergency order. I would not be comfortable with the legality of completely saying that people don't have to pay fees. What I've seen, as I said, is fees delayed. So my recommendation would be I would prefer to see village board action on that. And as Trustee Sadat pointed out, you could do that through a special meeting and handle it fairly expeditiously while still having an opportunity for staff input on it.
Thank you. Thank you for the information I'm looking for. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Trustee Sadat, anything further to add?
No, nothing further. I'm just, it's been about a month since we have been in this situation, and a lot of us are feeling the pain, financial burden, as well as many additional burdens that we do have while trying to regulate and navigate through this environment right now in this unprecedented time. So just if we could, beyond this topic, consider having that special board meeting where we do revisit this one more time, I think that would be a great way to go.
Thank you, Trustee Carballo. Anything further?
No, thank you.
Trustee Quetzal, anything further?
Thank you.
Trustee Dixit, anything further?
No, thank you.
And Clerk Chernow, would you please call the roll?
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. With that, any elected official reports this evening? We'll start with Trustee Wins.
I'm sorry. No, I think I can condense it into one for the Committee of the Whole. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Sadat.
Nothing at this time.
Trustee Hasse.
Nothing right now. Thank you.
Trustee Carballo.
Yes, just briefly, I'd just like to thank all the residents in Lisle for all they're doing to, you know, to beautify the community right now. From working at home recently, you know, from during this pandemic, I've had a chance to walk around Lisle and different neighborhoods in Lisle, and I see a lot of people out working in their yards, their gardens, putting mulch around the beds, and just beautifying the their homes. And it really does, it looks great, you know, when you see people out there, especially when they're social distancing and doing this work in their yard and improving the property. And everything looks beautiful. And not, now seeing everything turning green and the flowers and everything, it's just really nice to walk around the neighborhoods. I think that things are, you know, there's light at the end of the tunnel here. Things are going to be getting hopefully back to normal in the near future. And I think the economy is going to really start to pick up fast. I'm very hopeful that that's going to occur. And I really hope that we as a village can do everything and anything we can to try to help our residents and our businesses going forward and incentivize people to do things that are going to improve their homes, their businesses, and the Lisle community in the next few months. And I want to thank everybody for all they're doing now during this this very unprecedented, difficult time. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Quetzal.
Once again, just thanks to all the everyday heroes that we're all encountering on a regular basis, and prayers and best wishes to those for whom this time has been catastrophic.
Thank you, Trustee Dixit.
Just wanted to take a minute and say congratulations to some promotions that occurred.
I'm sorry, would you please try and adjust your microphone?
You're is that better?
That's better.
Just wanted to say a special thanks to some promotions that went on in the police department. Congratulations to two key people that are taking some great a huge responsibility. So, Chief Wilkie, thank you for organizing that and selecting the right team. That's it for me today.
Thank you. And I'd just like to close this tonight's meeting with just saying that about six, seven times a week, I participate in conference calls with mayors in the Chicagoland area, including Mayor Lightfoot. Conference calls with the governor, conference calls with the DuPage County Health Department. I can't be prouder of the residents of the Village of Lisle for responding to this difficult situation and how we're reacting to it and not overreacting, and we're respecting each other, and we're giving each other space and everything. It looks like things are turning for the better. I've gotten indications that the governor is still not decided on how long to continue the stay-at-home order, but we'll find that out shortly. But I wanted to share that with everybody. I also wanted to let everybody know that I think that we need to really take stock in what the total outcome is of this financial situation. I was alluded to earlier today that DuPage County may be extending the period to receive the first property tax payment, which means the villages and municipalities and other taxing bodies will not receive those deferred funds. So as we consider incentives or promotions or anything like that within our means, we also have to be cognizant that that our revenue may fall short. We have chosen to defer waive late fees due to the fact that commuters are not parking as much as they used to. Licenses and things are not being renewed if people aren't operating their businesses. So we've extended the period to file those. Anything beyond that we'll have to approve as a group. I also want to thank staff, thank everybody, thank this board for these accomplishments that we've made, not only in freezing taxes, but coming up with initial budget that was flat, and then responding within a matter of 2 weeks to a revised budget that took into consideration a very conservative effort to cut unnecessary spending, and in doing so within a budgeted means. I'm proud of the fact that we've reached out and negotiated purchases with vendors and received better pricing. Ultimately, this benefits everybody. And I'm lastly proud of the fact that that we've paid back a loan, although an internal loan, paid back a loan that affects different village taxpayers differently. I, for one, am not a Village of Lisle water customer, and I should not benefit from the water funds as a taxpayer. That belongs to a different group of people. That fund needs to earn its own interest income at a market rate, so that it can fully be funded and ensure that we continue to provide the most vital services that the village provides. That's one of those is providing water and then removing water from people's property. So that said, I'm pleased with the outcome today. I did hear from some residents regarding the annual fee ordinance, and like has been stated several times, we have to first adopt the fee ordinance and then take stock of our situation, find out what our projected revenues are and what our tax revenues are, and then take a look at services and fees for services that do incur costs for us. It's one thing to have staff provided services that we have to pay staff salaries for. It's another thing to have professional services that we outsource to other engineering companies and things like that we do incur fees for. So we have to balance this carefully as we consider it. So we'll move further on that, but other than that concludes my report. Any staff reports this evening?
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Just a few items. Just a reminder that the spring branch collection here in the village will start April the 27th. The schedule of locations is on our village website and on our cable channel 10. So the April 27th pickup will occur is south of Maple Avenue. Then week two, the week of May 4th, will happen in the north of the railroad tracks. And then the final week, May 11th, pickup will be between the railroad tracks and Maple Avenue. So we encourage residents to participate in that. Also a reminder, the draft zoning code is being updated. We have put that up on our website. It is available to be reviewed, and we'd encourage everyone to take a look at that and provide those comments to our development services team as those reviews happen. I'd also like to extend my thanks and gratitude to the great municipal staff that the village is fortunate to have during this pandemic and all year round. It's truly a privilege to work with each and every one of you, and thank you for your continued commitment to the organization and the community. And Mayor, I'd also like to thank you and the village board members for your commitment to the community. The village is certainly fortunate to have so many elected officials that care so much about this community. So thank you.
Thank you. With that, may I have a motion to adjourn?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Okay, we have a second.
Who is that? Was it Stephen?
Wins.
Wins.
Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and we are adjourned for the evening. We will reset the tape and we'll continue on with our committee of the whole meeting in about 5 minutes.